Welcome to our study today on the Gospel of Mark. I want to share just a few simple thoughts with you on the disciples and the need for rest that they have as we see them laboring for Christ in Mark chapter 6. And I want to read verses 30 through 34. And then I just want to take a few moments and comment on those verses today. So here we are in Mark chapter 6. Mark 6 and verse 30, we find these words. It says there, "And the apostles gathered themselves together unto Jesus and told him all things, both what they had done and what they had taught. And he said unto them, Come ye yourselves apart into a desert place and rest a while, for there were many coming and going, and they had no leisure so much as to eat. And they departed into a desert place by ship privately. And the people saw them departing, and many knew them, and ran afoot thither out of all cities, and outwent them, and came together unto him. And Jesus, when he came out, saw much people, and was moved with compassion toward them, because they were as sheep not having a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things." So as we come into this passage, let me just remind you what's taking place here. We see that Jesus' apostles return from their mission trip. Keep in mind in verses 7 through 13 that Jesus had sent them out on a mission trip. He had told them to go. He had given them some very specific instructions on going, the importance of having faith in him as they went and trusting him to supply their needs, and also that they would be obedient to proclaiming what it is that they were led of God to proclaim. Now, as they've come back from this mission trip, we see here that they gather themselves unto Jesus. In verse 30, it says, "The disciples gathered themselves together unto Jesus and told him all things, both what they had done and what they had taught." So as we see here, they set us a good example by gathering unto Jesus. And friends, our eyes need to ever be upon him. And we need to be reminded that he is central to everything, that he must increase and we must decrease. And as they come, they gather themselves around Jesus. And the Bible says that they rehearse all that they had done and all that they had taught in verse 30. And we need to be reminded of the fact that the servants of the Lord still need to return to him. And literally today, we can't return to him physically, but let me remind you that we can return to him in prayer, that we can come return to him in the Word of God, and we can rehearse before him what he has been involved in helping us do. And friends, that is wise for the Christian to do, because it reminds us of the simple truth that we are answerable to him, that we are accountable to him, and that we need to do his work in a way that honors and pleases him. There's a very specific way to do it. Not only has he called us to do his work in his power, but he has called us to do it his way. I just finished today reading through the book of Exodus. And one of the things that was reaffirmed in my mind once again as I read through the book of Exodus is in the last half of the book, God gives Moses the instructions, the blueprints for building the tabernacle. And he tells him, make sure you do it after the pattern. There's many times that he will tell them about a certain piece of furniture for the tabernacle or the tabernacle itself. And he says, make sure you do it according to the pattern. And as they built everything according to the pattern that God had given to him, the Bible then says when it was completed that the presence of God filled the temple. Friends, let me remind you, when it comes to serving God, God is giving us a pattern. God is giving us a blueprint, and we are not to err from that blueprint. And it really matters not what you and I think. What matters is what God says in his word, and that we do it according to the word of God. Paul reminded Timothy that a man is not crowned except he strive lawfully. And friends, it's not really important what we do for God, but it is of utmost importance how we do it. And these men return and they give account to God, remembering that they are answerable to him. And then we see here that the apostles are told to, after they have done this, to withdraw and to rest. In verse 31 it says, "And he said unto them, Come ye yourselves apart into a desert place and rest a while, for there were many coming and going, and they had no leisure so much as to eat." And, you know, as you look into these verses, there are a number of reasons that are possible that Jesus told them to withdraw and to rest here. We know that they had seen a tremendous amount of opposition from Herod, keeping in mind John the Baptist has just been killed by Herod. There was also a tremendous amount of opposition from the Jewish leaders toward the Lord Jesus Christ and his apostles. There was also, really people around them that were just absolute fanatics. And beyond that, they've been busy working for God, and God knew that there was the need there for them to rest. And, as I thought about rest, it's sad, but in many instances today, there are many Christians that do not need to be constrained to rest because many times when it comes to the work of God, they are simply too lazy and they're not busy enough in the work of God to ever get to the place that God would really have to encourage them to rest and to take a break. Friends, let me ask today as we think about that, what do you need as a child of God? Do you need the bridle? Do you need God to hold you back every once in a while and slow you down and tell you to rest? Or do you need a spur? Do you need God to spur you on and encourage you to be more faithful in your work for the Lord? Obedient servants of the Lord need time to come apart and to rest. And the truth of the matter is this, for those who are busy and active in serving the Lord, if we do not come apart and rest every once in a while, there's a good chance we could very well come apart. And so we need to understand that sometimes we need the rest that we need because we're physical beings, but at the same time, we can rejoice in the fact that our Savior needs no rest, that the one who keeps Israel and the one who watches over us, that he neither slumbers nor sleeps, as it says in Psalm 121. And then we see that Jesus seeks to lead his disciples away into a quiet place so that they can get some rest. It says in verse 32, they depart into a desert place by ship privately. So Jesus seeks to quietly get away with his disciples and bring them to a place where they can enjoy some rest. But in the course of doing this, the people anticipate what is going on. They watch him. Notice verse 33, the people saw them departing, and many knew him and ran afoot thither out of all cities, and outwent them, and came together unto him. So we see these people anticipating Jesus leaving, and even though he knows that his disciples need a break, and he seeks to lead them away quietly into a place where they can rest, we see here that these people anticipate where Jesus is going, and what they do is they simply walk around the shore and arrive where Jesus is going to be before Jesus even gets there. And I want you to notice what happens in verse 34. Jesus knows that his disciples are in need of a break. He's seeking to get his disciples to a place that they can have a break. And when they get to the other side, he sees the people there. And notice how Jesus has compassion on those people. It says, Jesus, when he came out, saw much people and was moved with compassion toward them because they were a sheep not having a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. The disciples of Jesus, his apostles, and Jesus himself are weary, they're tired. And Jesus knows that even more than the weariness that his disciples are experiencing here in the flesh, that these people need to hear from the Lord Jesus Christ. That their greatest need is the truth, and even though they're weary and tired, Jesus takes time to minister to them, and here's what we're going to find out tomorrow. The disciples of Jesus were in need of refreshment. But even though they were in need of refreshment themselves, Jesus uses them, even at a time when they are tired, to be a refreshment to other people. And friends, even when we're tired and we need a break, let me encourage you to never get so wrapped up in our needs that we fail to have compassion on the people that we come in contact with. May we be, as it says in Jude chapter 1 and verse 22, may we be at the place where we always have compassion and we seek to make a difference in the lives of those that we come in contact with. Jesus was moved with compassion in this verse. Let me ask you today, when's the last time you were moved with compassion toward the people around you that were in need of a Savior? Oh, friends, help us to have the compassion of the Lord Jesus Christ in our lives. Have a great day.